संयोगो योग इत्युक्तो जीवात्मा परमात्मनः, दैट इज द मर्जर ऑफ यूनिट कॉन्सियसनेस इंटू कॉस्मिक कॉन्सियसनेस इज योग। स्वाध्याय पाश्वाचार वीराचार एंड दिव्याचार। After millions of years, people have attained human form. In the course of evolution, people have passed through various stages of animal life, and as such, they have accumulated many animal propensities which become manifest in the unguarded moment of life. Humanity is a stage in the process of pratisanchara, whereby people have developed a special will which they can direct either towards Paramapurusha or towards gross matter in the path of negative pratisanchara. Human beings, due to their prominent past animal experiences, are drawn easily towards such experiences, whereas they feel less attraction towards subtle spiritual experiences. Tantra takes note of the basic human psychology, which closely resembles that of animals. Every individual has his or her own sanskaras or reactions in potentiality or complexes and sentiments. Initially, humans are ordinary animals. That is why the human beings has been called a rational animal. What is pardonable in lower life is unthinkable and intolerable in the case of humans, who has progressed a great deal in the course of spiritual evolution. Sarve cha pasavah santi talavad bhutale narah tesam jnanam prakashaya वीरभावः प्रकाशितः। वीरभावं सदा प्राप्य कर्मेण देवता भवेत्। इन द बिगिनिंग एवरी वन इज पशु एन एनिमल, बट व्हेन ए स्पिरिचुअल थर्स्ट डेवलप्स, दीज पीपल बिकम वीरा हीरोइक, एंड व्हेन दे आर फर्मली एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द वीरभाव, दे बिकम देवतास। In the crude state, everyone is an animal. In any case, the first lesson in spiritual practice are intended to elevate human from their animal tendencies, and those lessons are called pasavachar or pashubhava. With a continued spiritual practice according to the dictates of the master, the aspirant come to human status or virbhava. Animals need external pressure. In Pashvachar sadhana, one controls oneself to attain elevation to virbhava. Those beyond the animal stage cannot get elevation through external control only. They need external pressure and internal urge. With the rise of a spiritual aspiration, the aspirant becomes a veera, noble. When this veera bhava is fully assimilated, the person becomes godlike. In pasavachar sadhana, aspirants think of themselves in a term of animals, pashu, and think of their lord as a pashupati. They suffer from some sort of inferiority complex. They think themselves to be very ordinary persons and incompetent to follow higher spiritual practices. In the Virbhava stage, spiritual aspirants attain greater mental and moral force. They gradually start thinking that they are no longer an ordinary person. They overcome all their inferiority or fear complexes. They attain mental stability also. They are Veera, noble, and their Lord is Veereshwara. In Divyachara sadhana, they attain a still loftier state of mind and establish themselves in the realm of divinity. Here they are Devas, gods, and their Lord is महादेवा।